Hello guys, this is Curtin's channel. Now I represent to you the our fourth MOBA comparison mobile gaming. This is the Nautilus gameplay from widely League of Legends and Franco gameplay for the Mobile Legends. Okay guys, hopefully you enjoyed. Just take your popcorn and watch these two comparison video games. And let's start to the widely blocked League of Legends, the Nautilus. This is the tank Goliath. And here we go. Nautilus of the Wild Rift, League of Legends. We call Nautilus the Titan of Thieves. At a history of this legend, one of the champions, this a lonely legend as old as the first players, such as Bill Quarter. The armored Goliath known as Nautilus roams the dark waters of the coast of Blue Flame Isles. Driven by the forgotten betrayal, he strikes without warning, swimming in the enormous anchor to save the witch. And like the greedy of this doom, this is said, comes for those who forget to pee. The Bilgewater Titan, falling then down beneath of the whips with him. As an iron blood reminder that none can escape me and the thief. This is the giant Goliath, the hook maker. And now we proceed to their abilities. Nautilus abilities. This is the deep charge. Nautilus fire the shockwave into the earth that chases an opponent. This is shockwave rips up the earth above it, knocking enemies into the air. When it reaches the opponent, the shockwave erupts, chucking his target into the air and stunning them. Now guys, we are in the second skill. The second skill of Nautilus. This is the bridge line. Nautilus hurts him anchor forward. If it hits a champion, he drags both himself and the opponent close together. If it hits Terran, Nautilus instead pulls himself to the anchor, and the cordon of bridge line is reduced by half, and half of the mana cost is refunded. And we are in the second skill. I mean the passive in the first, and I mean the passive first skill, what I mentioned, and this is the second skill. Second skill of Nautilus ability, this is the Titan Rocks. Nautilus surrounds himself with a dark energy, gaining of the shield that blocks incoming damage. While the shield forces his attacks apply to the damage over him or takes to the enemies around his target. Now guys, his target to the enemies is the one who can do himself energy. It means if he de-hook the anchor, the opponent will be stunning. Not only one, but four or five of them. And that third skill of the Nautilus, we call as the Riptide. Riptide. Nautilus slams the ground, causing the earth to explode around him. A set of three explosions, each explosion damages and slows enemies. Okay, and the low ability is the deep charge. The deep charge meant that Nautilus fires a shockwave into the earth that chases an opponent. The shockwave rips up the earth above it, knocking enemies into the air. When the reaches of opponent, the shockwaves erupts, knocking his targets into the air and stunning them. This is the special skill of Nautilus. There's a lot more available skin for them, guys, because honestly, this is not already global. To our next champion, we call this Franco. Franco, that's why I compare with Nautilus, because they are basically have same similarity style, similarity, but the difference between them. Nautilus, when he threw his anchor and back to the opponent, is the one who can get it near to them, while Franco, he can hook him like a shockwave and stunning, and you cannot move within how many seconds. Now we call this champion, we call as Franco, the chop leader and the cook of the urban cook. Now guys, we are in Franco. We mention Franco, this is the name Franco, the tank champion. We call also as the frozen warrior. This is the Franco. We talk about the abilities of Franco, man, and the iconic goods. His roles is tank, specialty. This is initiator, controlling, and then commanding is the rumor. Okay, guys, Franco was released launch in 2016. Attributes of Franco, man, this is the movement speed. He had 260 physical attacks, so you can use also Franco as a fighter. He had already 160 attack damage, but he don't have any magic damage, man, so you cannot use magic damage for Franco. Now attack speed, he have only slow attack 0.826, and he got low physical defense started by 25, and magic defense he had also, but probably guys, Franco uses mana. He had started by the HP of 2709, and mana started at 440. Okay, now we talk about the ability of Franco, man. The ability of Franco, this is have a passive. Franco increase movement speed by 10% and regain 1% max HP per second if he takes no damage for a short time. Now we have the first skill of Franco. We call this one is Iron Hook. Franco launches in the Iron Hook to designated direction and hook the first target hit, and dealing 550, 600, 650, 700, 750 to 800, plus 100% total physical attack points of the physical damage and falling the unit to Franco. It means Franco can hook you to near him. Now we are talking in the second skill of Franco. This is the Fury Shock. The Fury Shock is the second skill and ability for this. The Franco lashes out, dealing 300 stat, 330, 360 until 450, plus 4% of his max XP physical damage to nearby enemies and slowing them by 70%. Remember guys, it's Franco release your second skill, so he can make 70% slowing from the opponent for 1.5 seconds. So how a great skill, man. And also Franco have a special skill. We call this the third skill and the last skill of Franco. Franco skill, we call this Bloody Hunt. Franco surprises and the enemy units of 1.8 seconds and then hack them for 6 times continuously. In Tagalog words, chop chop. Dealing with 60, 80, and 100 plus 70% total of physical attack points of physical damage with each hack. It means, guys, it's a big mistake if you have his hook and then follow with the last kill. We call this bloody hunt. Bloody hunt is no surprises, man, because it's the stand and you getting the standby and you cannot walk anyway. And now the history of Franco behind this champion, man. Franco started online chess at 2016, and this is the Frozen Warrior. Okay, and the Franco, if you know how to play Franco, man, you have unlocked Franco in the Mobile Legend. This is the Franco leveling up, the Warship Chip item build. You need the Warship Chip item build is the Hybridized Tank and Support build. And meanwhile, concentrators of the Rising and efficiency of Franco's crowd control skill and improving his ability to support his allies. Well, the build doesn't turn Franco into impregnable tank. It turns him into supportive fortress and provides beneficial buffs to his allies and impairing debuffs to his enemy. Man, these builds provide Franco the maximum amount of cooldown, reducing for his skills. For the reason, his core control skill became even more terrifying. After all, Franco Iron's hook, Fury Shock, and Brutal Massacre skill were all beat to damage and disable to the enemies with the item with enhancing of all Franco skill and providing better support mechanism. The Warship item build is the best build of Franco when it comes supporting allies to stopping enemies of their tracks. The domination eyes, this we have by 100 mana plus 70 armor, additional 5% critical chance reduction plus 15% cooldown reduction. This is the unique passive of Article to slow down nearby enemies 5% of their movement speed and 30% of their attack speed. You can use also the magic shoes. We have here plus 10% cooldown reduction plus 40 movement speed. So it's better to wear the shoes for Franco. You need to use the Oracle because Oracle have plus 850 HP plus 36 magic resistance plus 10% cooldown reduction. And the unique passive Bless improves health absorption of HP generation effects by 25%. And we need also the Courage Spillward. This is for the beginner. This is 750 HP plus 10% cooldown reduction. Unique passive bravely increase the attack powers and defense of nearby allies by 10%. So, and the Course Helmet, man. The Course Helmet. And then we called also Franco to use the Viking Warrior item. Depend on you guys. We have also the Tall Body item build. The Tall Body item build, this is for tank hero. The Tall Body item build is the most tanky build for Franco. This is build provides a lot of defense HP boost HP generation, cooldown reduction, and even the minor debuffs effect. At such as Franco defensive powers. If you all like Franco, may not all be a tanky as other tank heals, but this spell puts him near the level. But even so, Franco is more that supported tank than defensive tank. Franco's survivability is the highest with this build. That means he can soak a lot of damage without worrying much about getting killed fast. Therefore, he can cause ailments with his crowd control skill longer until his allies manage to deliver the finishing blows. If used efficiently, this spell may allow Franco to survive everything from the initiation of an attack to the delivery of the finishing blows. Ultimately, this spell goes out of full potential as attack. You need also the Domination Eyes, Dominance Eyes, Magic Shoes, Oracle, Sky Guardian, Helmet, Twilight Armor, Immortality. This is the last and the last of all bitch, the Immortality Man. From the beginning, Franco is the surprise's hero. Okay, and let's check about what are Franco's ability. Franco, the Mobile Legend. Trump. Is it where came from? Someone says this is a damage tanker. The damage tanker of all the Franco to play an expert. Franco also he can do better in mid lane. Because Franco is the first way how to kill. Now this is Franco also have a brutal damage, man. Then other than Nautilus. Nautilus is the opposite from Franco hook. Because Nautilus, if he threw his hook, he's the one nearby to the opponent. Sometimes, if you get a mistake, how to control it, you're the one who getting first kill. While Franco, the difference between them, if Franco passes the hook to the opponent, whoever that hook or slash the target and hits stunning after that, use the brutal damage. The brutal damage, what I say, is the engine of the button. Then we get Franco get tank, build, and also get fighter damage. It's not easy to use Franco, man. Because sometimes, if you throw your hook, problem is, you cannot do it. For the meanwhile, Franco cannot be the most tanker because he has a lot of damage. Now guys, I will tell you what is Franco's specialty. Okay, the Franco specialty is the legend among of all the legends. That easy to hook, but hard to use. That's the reality between them. Okay, hopefully guys don't forget to like and subscribe to my channel. We are carrying and fighting against the Lord, but the problem is we killed from them Okay. The weaknesses of Franco. Let me tell you the weaknesses of Franco. I think it's most cook because he cannot cook within the seconds. Okay, now we are discovery. We are discovery of Nutella's Men. Hopefully guys you enjoyed to the, our fourth episode. This is Nutella's gameplay versus Franco gameplay. This is the mobile comparison gaming. Now this we call Wild Rift, League of Legends versus the Mobile Legends. Why do I select Nutella's against Frank? Nutella's compared with Franco, because as far as I know, I'm a League of Legends player, guys. So I know how. I know whose hero we gonna be compared. If you do want some, you can comment below, guys. So don't also forget to like, subscribe, and click the bell. So if we make some video, you can notify. Man. Okay, hopefully do you enjoy our comparison video about these things. And one more thing about Franco and Otelius. So they are all the Goliath heroes. This is our the giant hooker. This is the man hook giant. Around these two games comparison. Hopefully you enjoy, man, and thank you for watching, and don't forget to like and subscribe and click the bell, man, so if I make another comparison video, so you notify us. Okay, enjoy, and thank you again once more.